All right, hey guys, this is Desiree Menken with Embracing30.com. In today's video, I'll be discussing basic gaming terms. We'll be using the PC game Portal Knights as an example while discussing. I have two special guests with me today. I have my husband, Chris. And
hello.
Hello. And one of my bestest friends, Chris.
Hello.
thank you guys for... there's my husband up there as Hansel. I'm Paulina Consuela. That's my character.
I'm still in the works.
And Chris is still in the works for his character. This is a game that you can customize your characters before you start. So this is why... sometimes it takes a lot to get the right character, because it does have a lot of really cool features. I just did mine really quick. It, you know, just looks like me. But you can make it customized. You can do different hairstyles, all kinds of cool stuff. But throughout this particular short gameplay, we're going to discuss gaming terms, just basic gaming terms. And Chris, again, feel free to add your gaming knowledge and expertise if you would like, as we're going through each term. So a bit of background to this game. It is Portal Knights, as I said. An RPG gaming is the medium for it. This game is an early access, so that means it is still in development. It has not been fully released to the public. It's still in the works, so there's still a lot to do and that's going on with it. So I guess we'll just go ahead and get started with gameplay and term elements. So the first section that we're going to talk about is thematic game elements. The first definition is story. We went over this in class. If you are not in my class, feel free to, you know, listen along or, you know, comment or email me on things that you'd like to see as well in these lessons. But the first term we went through in class is story. The plot line of the game created by game developer. Just as in a book or a movie, games can tell stories about characters in the worlds through their choices and actions. Players can also create their own stories as they play the game. So you can see that the storyline is obviously medieval, and crafting as well. Olga has joined. Welcome, Olga.
Yes. Hello,
Olga. And with her sideburns, lovely. Very nice. So you can zoom in first person. This is first person. This is what? There's first person and what? Third person, there you go,
thank you.
I'll be reading from notes, so you'll be hearing some paper rustling, as well as I get absent-minded because I get easily distracted too. All right, so anything to add, guys, to the word story? The plot of this is mainly just knights and medieval. You have ogres and these little blobs and stuff like that. All right, the next word is setting. Setting is a fictional environment in which a game occurs. The setting tells the time and place of the game and its background. So this setting is, again, medieval. It's kind of fantasy, a lot of fantasy. It reminds me of, what was that game? Minecraft. That's what I was thinking about. Reminds me a lot of Minecraft. So it's really, really cool. Kind of the setting here is kind of a Minecraft.
Upgraded Minecraft.
Upgraded Minecraft, thank you. That's an excellent way to put it. Yes. Character. The word character is an imaginary person or being who is controlled by one of the participants, a game master, or the game itself. A non-player character is controlled by the game. So as you can see, these characters in Portal Knights are controlled by us, the player. Next is gameplay elements. Uh-oh. Okay, sorry, I'm also playing too, so that's another thing I get very distracted with. It's not dying. Very good. Alright. Gameplay elements. The first word on that is play sequence. The order in which players take actions and how those actions flow together. Some games are real-time, which you can see right now. This is real-time. You're playing with other people and their time as well. And where players or player can take actions constantly. So this is definitely a real-time play sequence. Other games, like Monopoly, are turn-based, and the sequence determines the order of the terms. Other games mix real-time and turn-based. Next is level design, the process of creating the spaces in which players work to achieve objectives. I guess the level design in this one is... Where is it? Where's the portal? The objective of this one, since it's still in early development, there's no clear ultimate goal. Is there a clear goal on this one?
I'm not sure. There might be a final boss, but we have not gotten there yet.
Okay. But from what we've seen, it's, you know, collect shards. I have a cape. Collect blue shards. Did you just clap? You can do that? How are you doing that?
Like taunting.
Oh, wow.
What?
Yeah, he's doing stuff. Okay, so the objective here... Thank you. It's bad. Very nice. All right. So you learn stuff about... learn new stuff all the time. All right, so the objective is just to create portals, to create a way to get to the other levels, as you can see in the map here. That indicates a boss, and then the question marks are unexplored areas of our team, or our players. What was that? Interface design, the process of developing effective methods for communication between players and games. The interface includes how players provide input to the game and how game communicates the result of the input to the player. Okay, so Portal Knights doesn't have... Does it have, like, a way to communicate with the other players?
Yeah, you can do through text if you hit enter.
Okay.
Yeah, you can chat on the...
Okay, so if you can see in the bottom left, pressing enter and then just putting... You know, you can put whatever. Hello. I'm Hansel. Get it right. All right, sorry. That bothers me. For those of you in my class, I will be checking spelling. No, I'm just kidding. but yeah, that's a way to communicate. We are actually communicating vocally through our own ways through, what is it, BattleNet?
Yeah, this is BattleNet, but there's lots of different applications you can use.
Okay, so different ways you can communicate with other players if you don't have a headset or have a microphone like ours, and yeah, you can press enter in the game, or you can, you know, figure it out, or have the same person in the same room, if that's possible. So that would be interface design. Awesome. All right, next section is gameplay analysis. So difficulty is the amount of challenge for players to complete a game objective. I don't think in Portal Knights there is a difficulty level, is there?
I don't believe so.
I don't think so. I haven't seen it.
Usually you can see, you know, with gameplay options, there's an easy mode, hard mode, medium mode, kind of stuff like that. Show tutorials, whatnot. It does not look like there is one here.
This one's kind of the farther you go in levels, the harder it gets.
Okay. But you can level. And that's where this comes from. So you can do...
Yeah, once you
attributes.
Start building the portals, if you go too fast and you're not leveled high enough, then that's a little more difficult.
Okay. So
as
that...
we found out.
Yeah, several times we have found that out. In this game is that we are way too lower level to be in a certain area. But other games, like, you know, I'll go back to Monopoly a couple times. Monopoly, the difficulty depends on the age a lot of the times. You know, is it for, or grade level? You know, sometimes they have for first graders or for you know, high schoolers, stuff like that. You know, it depends on what you're learning in school. Will depend on, you know, the level as well. All right, balance. A description of the relative strength of different game attributes. A competitive game is balanced if all starting positions, character, classes, roles, etc., have a roughly equal chance of being successful. So that would be, this is a good balanced game. We all start off on the same level when we created our character to begin with. Since I'm not playing as much as they are right now, they are gaining a lot more, they're gaining better levels as they're practicing, they're fighting enemies, and they're also leveling their equipment too, as I'm talking. So they're definitely going to do a lot better in this game than I will at this point. I need to have my wand out. Okay. I have made no contribution to that. Alright. Yeah. So it can be competitive, you know, psychologically. You definitely want to be better than the other players. But you also want to help your group. That's a cooperative game. Balance is also applies to choices that players make. So, you know, if you make the choice to, you know, in this game to level different things faster than somebody else, like if he were to level his bow faster than I level my wand, yeah, that would be something. Or if I dodged in a correct way, that would definitely help. So, you know, that's a way to have good balance. The next one is depth, the capability of a game to support or appeal to a broad range of strategies or skill levels. A game with simple rules can still be complex and allow you to have complicated strategy and skill mastery. But deep games generally have more replay value than shallow games. So this is definitely a deeper game replay value wise. Because, you know, you can do different things. You can build as well. Like I said, it's kind of like Minecraft. You can build and level. So the replay value is definitely higher in this game, as would be probably an example of a shallow game compared to this one. Anybody? Anybody?
I'm trying to think. I usually don't play too many shallow games. Something like a card game, maybe, or a board game. I guess like
Magic.
Ooh.
Candy. What was that?
Then be fighting.
Candyland.
Yeah. That also depends on the level. You know, if it's too easy of a game, that could be definitely a shallow game. But since there's more challenges in leveling in this game, it definitely has that replay value. So that's a good example, like Candyland. For everybody out there that, you know, is just way beyond Candyland. Alright, so the next one is pace.
Uno.
Huh?
It's an Uno.
Uno. Yeah, Uno. I mean, that can be considered a shallow game because it's a very quick game and it only has one set of rules, really. And it, you know, you play it over and over again and the chance is high, you know, the variety is high, but still, it's the same basic principles. So yeah, good example of that one as well. Another example of a deep game would definitely be any of the Elder Scroll games, where you can, again, build characters, levels, stuff like that. Another deep game is Risk. It's a board game.
Oh yeah, definitely.
That one definitely has high replay value. Change my wand real quick. Start leveling.
You got your pet already?
What? You got a one. Pet?
Did yes.
You? I do.
There's a mouse. There's a rat.
You're doing alright.
Did not know there was a pet mouse.
Wait,
oh, yeah,
go?
No, I thought I. Okay. Alright, so the next one is.
Give Desiree.
I did replay value. I already did replay value. Didn't I? No, replay value is the characteristics of being able to play a game multiple times while continuing to have fun.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. How do I Oh, I thought I had a tail for a little bit. All right. Thank you. Thank you for my pet rat.
You're welcome.
All right. Age appropriateness. The age or maturity level of the players for which a game content is appropriate. Determined by elements such as language and violence. So this one does have violence in it, obviously. But, it, you know, they're fantasy characters. Is that what you're fighting? Age appropriateness. You know, definitely this is for anybody, I think. Portal Knights. You know, there's different ratings like E for everyone or M for mature, stuff like that. Again, with the age range. One that would, I guess, is obvious for not younger kids is, what is it called? Yep, Grand Theft Auto, that's what I was thinking.
Definitely
not a younger crowd. But games like this and, would beat up pretty well. What other games are age appropriate like this game?
Minecraft?
Yeah.
Very similar though.
Yeah, it is very similar.
Mario World, that type of stuff. Super Mario.
Sonic. What about board games?
Candyland.
Candyland? Yep, that's for everybody.
There's that one we played, Takedo.
Oh, Takedo, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, that's a good one.
What was the King of Tokyo?
That was a good one. Yes. That's a board game.
I have not played that one in so long. I completely forgot about that one.
I saw that at the store the other day. I was like, oh.
Memories.
We play it again.
We should play that one again.
Do you have any expansions for it?
No.
Because I saw some
expansions. Yeah, there's a couple expansions. There's also another one. I think it's King of New York.
That's another really good game replay value is expansions.
Yes.
If you get bored with one game, you can just add an expansion and boom, new game.
If it has one.
If it has one, yes.
So many more possibilities.
Exactly. Another one I'm thinking about. Oh gosh, it's not. Is it Civilization?
Huh?
Civilization, is that what I'm...
Oh, yeah, online. Not on the computer.
I'm thinking about the board game that's... Oh, gosh.
Oh, are you talking about Risk again?
No, it has, like, big cards or cardboard.
Oh, I know what you're... They were, like, the little hexagon-looking things.
Yeah!
Oh, Settlers of Catan?
Settlers of Catan.
No.
Well, that's another one. But, now I'm thinking about... Like, it has Egypt and Alexandria.
Seven Wonders.
Oh, yeah, Seven Wonders.
That's what I was thinking about. Seven Wonders has a lot of expansions, doesn't it?
No, I think it only had one or two.
Really?
No, the other one had it. What'd you
Dominion
say?
Dominion has a lot of expansions.
Yeah, Dominion
they're
has
all
a
up
ton
there.
Of expansions.
Yeah.
I mean, I've got like eight of them, and then there's probably six more, if not more, by then. I don't know.
Did you go in this dungeon already?
Yeah, we did.
Oh, that's where you got your little pet.
Mm-hmm.
Have you already been
Since
here?
You didn't want it, I gave it to Desiree.
Oh, you didn't want the rat?
Nope.
I guess.
He's got too high of standards.
It's adorable. I'll call him Remy.
Remy, make me some ratatouille.
Alright, next section. Oh, what'd you find?
Look at this. Chris.
What, where are you?
Look what I got around me.
Are you Paulina Consuela?
No, that's Desiree.
I am.
Oh, yeah.
I'm Paulina
I'm
Consuela.
Oh, yeah, there you are. Hansa.
I used a potion and I got this cool shield around me.
Isn't that the caterpillar from Bug's Life?
What?
Was his name Hansel too?
Hansel?
Well, what is that?
Heimlich. His name is Heimlich.
Oh, yeah, Heimlich.
From the Bug's Life.
I'm a potion.
Oh, Hansel, I'm thinking from Shrek.
Oh, you're thinking of. Oh. Alright.
How'd you get the little shield around you? What'd they do?
He said
it was
a potion.
Armor potion. It's gonna go away in a few seconds. I think it only lasts 60 seconds.
Well, it's been like 190 seconds.
I'm moving on to the next section.
Alright.
Look at my outfit. It's so shiny.
My outfit is very shiny.
Oh, did you already get your first set?
Yeah.
Hey!
So you're still in the last. This is the last one.
Y'all have a workbench?
Yeah, there's one over in the house.
Yeah, it's in that house.
What house?
Did you need a pickaxe?
Over here.
Or a pickaxe, yeah.
No, I should make a pickaxe.
I got the supplies for it.
Okay, sorry. Moving on to the next one. Next section is related terms. These are just various terms. Just basic ones. Single player is a game with only one player. Like, this one can be a single player. It can also be multiplayer. But single player is the objective of single player games may require a player to complete against an element of the environment, against his or her own skill, against time, or against chance. So like I said, this one can be, thank you. This one can be a single player game. This is often referred to as, or you can refer to as solitaire, is a solitaire play, particularly with card games. Next one is multiplayer, is a game or a game mode with more than one player, such as this one, like somebody shooting you with arrows that is on your
That's
team.
Chris.
game I'm
can
building.
Be a multiplayer game can be cooperative, competitive, or both. This is I think this one's both cooperative and competitive. What do y'all think?
I think it's cooperative. But some people are very competitive and bring that into the game.
I don't know.
I am very friendly here.
Well, since I don't know who they're talking about, I'm just going to move on. A cooperative game is a game where players... Huh?
You need a stone pickaxe?
Yeah, I was going to get some stuff. A cooperative game is a game where players can work together to meet objectives, like finding a portal, such as this game. A competitive game is a game where not all players can meet the objective. So technically, this can be a competitive game, because you guys are doing all the work, I'm just talking. So technically...
Like usual.
So technically, my competitive, you know, nature will say, hey, these guys are doing better than I am. Psychologically, it can be competitive, again, to me. And ultimately, it's supposed to be cooperative. Turn-based is a game divided into separate and distinct opportunities to take action. Again, that's basically like Bignopoly, where you roll the dice, and once you're done with your turn, it goes on to the next person. Contrast with real-time games. Like I said, real-time is a game in which players can take actions as fast as they physically or psychologically are able to. Like, this one is definitely a real-time game. So, you know, if I were to go up to an enemy right now...
hey, I gave you your pickaxe.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. If I were to go up to enemy right now, I would have to rely on my skills to be able to... It's an enemy. Did you kill all the enemies?
Possibly.
I'm going to have to run all the way. I don't have any shoes. I just realized that now. So this is definitely a real-time game. If I were to go up to an enemy right now, I don't know where one would be. One could probably be in here.
You did mage, right?
I did mage, yeah. So let's see if we can find an enemy in here somewhere. It's gotta be around here somewhere.
I don't know, we might have killed them all. Wait, I hear someone.
I'm gonna come back.
Oh, there
I hear
we
someone
go.
Up here.
There's an enemy.
Oh,
I see.
So this is basically the real time where I have to rely on my skills to be able to take out that slugworm, whatever it was. Or I would, you know, perish in the game. Oh, wow, I found a nice water fountain. My goodness, this is beautiful. Oh, look at that.
You need to come see this.
This is cool. I will stand here until you get here. Oh!
Did you just fall down?
Let's see. Strategy. Strategy is gameplay in which success is direct result of having and using a plan to achieve objectives. That's a strategy. So our strategy here, we don't have one that I know of. I'm just... Yeah. They might have a strategy. They probably do. Reflex, a gameplay based on a physical action. The player uses hand-eye coordination or equivalent to achieve game objectives. This can range from whole body motions, like kicking a soccer ball towards a goal, to timed button pushing in video games. So that is reflex. Chance is gameplay in where an objective completion is challenged by a specific variety of gamer it is out of the gamer's control. It is a randomized tension. So that one is definitely like Uno. Or at the beginning of this game, the next level we move on to could be by chance. It could have something completely different from this one.
I found it.
What'd you find?
How'd you get there?
Your little oasis.
My little oasis off a cliff. And then we have two more. Abstract is a game that does not have a theme, like checkers or Uno. Thematic is a game's topic. Does not directly affect the gameplay, but provides emotional or mental foundation.
Lantern.
It's what? Oh, wow.
There.
Oh.
Objective. Oh, wait, thank you.
Hey.
Ah. We've gone competitive.
Now this is competitive, yes. And then last one, again, is theme, is the game's core topic. Does not directly affect the gameplay, but provides emotional... provides emotional or mental foundation for a game designer or a game player. So the theme of this one, circling back to what we talked about before, is kind of like... I was going to say Skyrim, but that's not right. Just like Skyrim meets Minecraft. Right? I think so. Ooh, snap.
Yes.
Yes, I guess it's definitely more, I leveled.
No.
Finally leveled.
How'd you level? You weren't doing that.
I wasn't doing anything at all.
I got a whole suit. I got...
Alright, so that's it for... Oh, congratulations, you leveled two.
Yeah, I did.
Alright, so that's it for the gaming terms. If you have any questions, email me, comments, email me. Or you can wait for the next class to discuss if you learned anything from this one. Again, these are all terms that we went over in class. This is just an example of what those terms mean when it comes to an actual gameplay like this one. Again, this video wasn't required for class. It was just something fun for you to watch.
Expand your little
brain. Expand your what?
Expand your little minds.
That was rude.
But informative.
Enormous minds.
Your enormous minds, yes. Add more to what already you already know.
Knowledge.
Knowledge, yes. Thank you. Alright, so...
And as always, if you liked it, give it a thumbs up.
Give a thumbs up, like if you liked it, comment. Negative comments are welcome. As well.
Constructive
feedback, not negative feedback. Constructive feedback is always welcome.